wanted them to believe. But they told us to take another path. They told us to keep our day jobs. And they told us it wasn't our time. That we would never make it. They whispered in our ears. They screamed, but you gotta fail! No! Good morning, artists! We're not hungry. We are starving. We are not tired. We are awakened. Get the sketchbooks out, because today, we are not done. No! We are artists! And today has just begun! We are here to listen, to learn, to grow. We are here to overcome. We are here to be better artists, and may I dare say, better people. Yes! We are done losing. We are done standing still. Today, we are going to make our best art, and today, we are going to break our old boundaries. We are going to find new ground, new world, better tomorrow. This isn't just about finding ourselves. This is about finding out about everything. Yes! We are artists! We are artists! Yeah! 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 We are not gonna stop. Nothing's gonna stop us. That's right. Yes, yes, yeah! Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Dustin Payette. This is Good Morning Artist. Are you ready to create? How we doing? A little bit better, huh? I mean, I'm trying to do new things. I'm trying to have a live chat today, and I got nothing. Nothing over here. It just says comment now in my face. I'm supposed to have, like, scrolling words. I don't know, guys. Hey, you know, I'm an artist. I don't know how to do these little widget thingies. All right? You know, like, they're like test widget, and it's like, I don't know. It's working, I guess. Then I get on and nothing, you know? Nothing. Okay, listen, we got painting today, guys. We're doing the painting. Um, We're gonna do a cool painting today. And I've been doing like a lot of cool like little mini paintings. I don't know, maybe you guys seen some of the videos. But yeah, you know, we're doing our thing. And we've got a little digital art, you know. Now, if you're new to the show or anything, hello, Finders Keepers, hello, my father, everybody, is watching live. I have my own TV show. I guess maybe that means I made it. Does it? I mean, at this point, listen, let's get this chat out of the way, because, it ain't working like it was supposed to. I'm gonna work on that. I mean, because wouldn't it be fun if you guys could, like, you know, have your chat pop right up on my show or something. So I'm gonna work on that. I thought it was gonna be cool today. I'm gonna have that chat up. It's gonna be good. We are painting today. We're gonna oil paint today. You know, like, I've been doing a lot of clip studio art online, and everyone's like, when are you gonna paint though? When are you gonna paint? It's always, when are you gonna paint? It's gonna be now! I'm gonna paint now. We're gonna do it today. We're gonna paint. I got this beautiful scene. It's like I stole a scene from Holland online. I wanted to paint something that looked like Van Gogh. And, I got something started. You know, I'm gonna continue on and finish that up. It'll probably take me an hour. But I'm gonna do it live. It's gonna be amazing. Shane, thank you. Yeah, club, please. When you're out there, you know, and I need tips, don't be afraid. This is not a how-to show, art show. I'm learning with you guys. You guys got your sketchbooks out. I got my sketchbooks out. We're learning. I'm learning how to do a chat room on my live stream. It'll be amazing. And Good Morning Artist Club. Hey, maybe you got your mug out. Maybe you're helping me get a little better at the show. Now, You guys know about the mug, right? The Good Morning Artist mug. All right, you know, I know some of you got it out there. I'm raising glass to you right now. These mugs, I mean, they literally hold like an incredible amount of liquids to drink. They hold almost all the liquids I try to put in here, minus hydrochloric acid or something like that. It's just an incredible mug. It has my signature on it. That probably devalues it a little bit, I know. But, you know, if you go over to the Patreon page, you can get one. You can get a mug. And you can get a bunch of things. Let's talk about the things you can get real quick. And then I'm going to go painting. And then we're going to go painting, okay? I'm getting to it! I'm going to paint! I know, it's an art show. Do you see this, man? Yeah, it's a pretty good painting. It's going back there. It's almost done. Alright, listen. Alright. Let's check out some of the other things that you can get on the Patreon. Here we go. Boom. We're going right over. Yada! You want the I Love All Cats video? No video, poster. The I Love All the Cats poster. And it's got all the cats on it. I promise you. And if you needed another one for some weird reason, I'll make it and put it on there. But here we go. Got all the cats. I Love All the Cats. You can get this for the $3 club. And everybody, if you have posters, I have a bunch of piles of posters still that I still haven't gotten out to some of you Patreon guys. So make sure you're not too worried about it. And if you're desperate for a poster, I'll do it right away. But I kind of like to casually run into you guys and then give you all your merch, you know? And then the other guys, you know, you can get this one right now for the $3 one. And if you did any other tier above the $3 one, it's in your package. It's in your package. It's in your little group, your full file of all the posters. Some of you are still waiting on the Christmas poster. I have it here for you. Okay? This one's for my sister. I know, you're just like, oh my god, you haven't seen your sister. It's literally thinking the same thing today. And this one is the Snow one. I know I got my friend Tommy coming into town. His postman's there. He's been in Colorado, and you know, I didn't want to ship it to Colorado while he's moving and everything. Those type of things. I know some of you, I'm just going to see you eventually. Others, I mail them out right away. You know, maybe you're a little farther away. But you can get the winner poster for a dollar. And all you guys have to do is go over to the Patreon page. And I'm going to pop that up for you to show you what this looks like. One second here. View page. Okay, now we're talking. Now we're talking. Okay, see? It's really easy. You got the poster one, winner, black coffee, dollar. You get that. You do the $3, guess what? You're gonna get the winner poster and the cat poster and some other things. Maybe I'll sell you some music. You do the $10 one, eggs, Benedict, and bacon. You get both posters and you get some secret music videos and stuff. Alright? And then we got, you know, you can get your own personal framed winner poster. Or you can do, you know, the mug exclusive for ballers. Only the Good Morning Artist ballers have the mug. Let's face it, fam. When you gotta roll big, you gotta get the mug. You do, and I really appreciate the support. And this is my favorite way for you guys to support me is the Patreon page. Because, you know, it kind of helps me think of, you know, like, plan. Because, you know, it's like... It's a subscription, but, you know, I make it really cheap. You guys can support me for a dollar a month. I don't want to mess up anybody's finances out there, so I try to make it as really cheap as possible. Alright, we're going to get to some painting. Ziller, good morning. Good morning to you. We're going to get to some painting. I think we're going to do a quick break, though. And I'm going to get to some painting. Hold on. Let me give you a little teaser on the painting sheet. Okay? I got this going. Commission work for emotes. Not really sure what that means, but yeah. I do take commissions. How fast you get them depends on, a lot of it. But yeah, you know, you guys can send in commissions. I do those. But I got this painting. Now you can see I have done a red monochrome with some Alizarin crimson. And Mr. West does do commission pieces, yes. Dusty West is actually dead. But me, Dustin Payette, who, you know, at one point was Dusty West, does do commissions. Now you can see on this painting I've done a red monochrome, and I'm going to use the red kind of as my darks, and I'm going to keep those reds in there when I need to keep the darks, you know what I mean? And then after the break we're going to go with the color, and we're going to put our blues, our greens, our browns, we're going to do all the things, and I want you guys to get your sketchbooks out, and I want you guys to get your oil paints out, and I want you guys just to you know, be excited about today. It's raining outside, so it's a perfect time just to sit down for an hour or so and sketch away and do just sketch literally anything that's in front of you. Sketch perspective, sketch the light, sketch the shade, okay? Get the pencils, get the crayons out. I want it all out! And let's work together, all right? And we're gonna take a little break. We'll be right back, guys. Okay. Yeah, you know. Okay, I'm setting up the paints here. We're doing good. Let's go over. Let's go right over. Let's go check out this painting a little bit. And, you know, we're going to talk about why I got fired a little bit. But you can see I got this painting here going. And I got this blue here. And I've got too much. I don't know if you guys can see this really well. I've got too much oil on it. Okay? You can see I kind of just tried to make a little mix here. And it's a little fat. So what I got here is some beautiful cobalt blue. Raw. Beautiful. This is a Illuminate Blue. Spinal. I don't even know. I have to wear a mask when I do that too. Because you don't want to get that stuff in your nose, obviously. I got to mix a little bit of that in. And, you know, we're going to get some tunes here going. Yeah, I got this job at the mobile station, and, you know, I worked a couple shifts. It was pretty groovy, you know. What if I turn this around here? Okay, we're doing okay. It was pretty groovy. You know, I like the people and everything. You know, but, I do smoke weed because, you know, I kind of deal with anxiety, I guess. It is. It's either anxiety or depression, but I think it's just more anxiety. I used to think it was depression, but I'm not really depressed. You know, I poured some of this in there. I'm just going to try to mix it back in a little bit. So, you know, I went and took a break. And I smoked pot in the mobile bathroom. And, you know, the girl I was working with, she asked if I smoked pot in the bathroom. And I said no. But she still told the boss that I did. And then I did, you know. So, I had to say I did. He's like, I gotta let you go because you're smoking weed in the bathroom. And I said, okay. Okay. I don't know what to do. You know, it makes me feel better. I just don't know what to do. So, you know, I just gotta make more money in painting, I guess. I don't know. And, you know, this is why you're supported. So I just can't do it, guys. I don't know what to do out there anymore. I can't function in society anymore. It's like I'm really a normal person too. Like I really do so many normal things. I just sit around doing normal things every day. You know, but I just have to smoke weed. I don't know. I think a lot of people think I'm just like a drug addict or something. But like I'm like highly productive every single day. I get a lot done. I mean, obviously, I have my own live stream, so that's getting something done. You can see I'm getting a little bit better mix here. And I'm still not 100% liking it. It's still a little fat, but we're way better. And I think when I mix this down with some white, which I'm going to have to do, it's going to be okay. So now we got some really good pure cobalt blue here to work with. I mean, the color is just slapping. It's just the blue. It's like the America blue, you know? That's what you see on the flag. That is blue. But you know, when you add a little white, we're gonna have some really good sky colors. The cobalt blue is really known. I mean, now I can take my mask off. Cobalt Blue is really known for making skies very well, and I can't wait to put this down. I'm gonna put this down over this red here. And I used, I'm still debating on how to say this the best way. Alizarin Akhunzon. Okay, and we're gonna use maybe some Prussian blue, maybe somewhere in here. I don't know if I'll need it though, because I got the cobalt. We're gonna go titanium white, and you know, brilliant pale yellow. And I'm hoping just to make this explode with some really good greens, some really good blues up here. I'm keeping the reds in there for my darks. And we're gonna see how this goes. I haven't really painted like this before. So this is kind of a new idea for me. Let me get some brushes here. I cannot wait to put this blue over here a little bit. Now what I like to do, titanium white is just white. It's just the white. It's in the middle. It's not cool, it's not warm, it's just white. It's like the white is white. So like a lot of times I try to get warm tones. So I'm going to use a warm tone white, because a brilliant yellow, extra pale. You know, it's just got the tiniest bit of yellow tint in it. And I use that, so when you mix yellow with white, it's just yellow. But you kind of like, I want a warm white, so I use these Williamsburgs, yellow, extra pale. So it's kind of like in a warm tone. So sometimes when you got light bouncing off of something, you don't want it to be white, because then it looks like fluorescent lighting almost. And then you use the little bit of yellow. I'm gonna get a paintbrush. I'm just gonna dig right into this right here. I just cannot wait. Let me see. I'm trying to get my light best. Thank you, Taylor. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. I'm a little disconnected from the chat a little bit. I'm gonna try to move it actually so I can still see you guys chatting away a little bit here. I feel really comfortable today. I feel relaxed today with you guys around. And as always, we got some of the coolest music ever made in Rochester here, and mostly my bands. Okay, let's get this blue in here. The guy I study mostly is Van Gogh. I mean, who doesn't want to study Van Gogh all day, every day? He's just such an interesting character. And I hope you guys, here, I can see what you guys can see. I got this blue here. And I'm reading this big, huge book on Van Gogh. I've been reading it for like 2 years. You know, and I take breaks. We've moved and everything into a new house, and we had to take a break from a lot of things. And I've been reading this Van Gogh book. You know, of course, everybody likes to read about Van Gogh. So you know, I see a lot of paintings by Van Gogh, and I kind of just want to paint it a scene that he might have painted, you know. And some of the windmills that he literally painted are still up there in Holland, so it's kind of amazing. You can literally go paint a Van Gogh scene, that's really a romantic thought, isn't it? Thinking about painting the same thing, same scene that maybe Van Gogh did. And
Man, I kind of want to think about it all day. I want to be there too. Maybe someday I can get the courage to do some traveling and go out to Europe and maybe and indulge myself. That sounds like a pretty dreamy thing. I know the rest of the world doesn't always want to see Americans around. But hey, if they would like to indulge me, I'm trying to paint like Van Gogh. Van Gogh knew like 4 languages and, you know, and a half. Probably a good amount of Latin too. He was actually really smart. But also just so weird. Just do the weirdest things all the time. Everybody knows he chopped his ear off. There's so many other interesting things. And probably the most interesting thing is that he wrote all those letters to his brother Theo. His brother Theo paid for everything. Which sometimes sometimes that ends up being the weirdest part of the Van Gogh story for me. And like, I just want people to understand how far we've come from this. Van Gogh's brother Theo could support him, his wife, and Theo, or in Van Gogh, all on one income. Yeah. And he worked at the freaking poster store, I don't know. I mean, it's just looking beautiful, isn't it, you guys? The blue. It's just looking so beautiful. Working with this cobalt. Very, very raw cobalt here. I kind of, you know. What should I do here? I mean, am I trying to do a little Van Gogh style on here? I can't put the heavy amount of paint that he puts down.
Oh, we got an alert?
Oh, my wife has shared the stream. Oh, by the way, if you guys, you know, new followers and everything, they get alerts now. And what is it? In the way here. What is this thing in front of my camera? It's this light? It's this light. Okay. I gotta figure it out. Okay, so now I'm like dark and gloomy because the light's in front of me. I'm working. Anyways, on the amount of paint that Van Gogh uses, he uses like globs of paint. I can't. I'm sorry, Van Gogh. I just can't. I mean, you see his globs of paint. You can think of these like really passionate strokes of just like scooping in and like brushing it across really heavily, you know, like he was like a maestro or something. The other thing that's weird is like, listen, he's going out on the fields. There ain't no music. You ain't got no iPod. You're just out there. With your own thoughts. I mean, that seems like it would make you mad enough. Just on that, you know? We just have such a luxury with music all the time in the modern era. I mean, I don't know. I'm like, when I do all my art, I'm almost constantly entertained during it too. Like I'll have some music on, or maybe I just have a movie on in the background. You know, it's like so rare that I'm literally just the only thing I'm doing is working on my art, and maybe that's bad. I just don't know, you know? Half of it is I have to be productive. And, you know, you have to do things that motivate you. So, you know, sometimes just putting on maybe a documentary about art just gets me motivated. You know, and then, of course, putting on music will get you motivated to do things. And I just feel like painting however I want. Maybe I am coloring booking this out a little bit, but I really just don't even mind. I'm really happy about it. You know, I did a good sketch, and I did a good monochrome. And maybe I am just coloring in right now, but I like it. Maybe I kind of, now I'm feeling a little stormy now. Out of nowhere though. I'm feeling a little stormy out of here now. Now I just wanna like, attack this. I don't know. This is really wild. Felt that. Like somebody was telling me just to go a different way. It's like kind of like I'm kind of like maybe I'm working. I just like, you know, first every stroke is delicate, but you paint some more and then you get a little excited about maybe your end result, you start painting faster and faster. And you can't tell, you're in that line between whether that's a good or bad. Am I making mistakes? Am I not caring enough? Am I doing what I'm supposed to be doing? And then, you know, you hear the command to break the rules in the background. You just have to. You do. You just go after it. You break the, you know. just rambling. Total rambling.
Let's check the chat. Cool. People like the setup.
Relaxing. That's cool. You know, I know how it is out there. Everybody's been like, when you painting? At the Clip Studio art, just with the live stream, you know, or the Photoshop up on the screen, it's obviously very easy to do. That's a simple setup for me. You know, and these paintings, I had to get a second camera. I'm still not really, like, that happy with it, but, I love that these are here. It kind of like adds. They kind of like need to be thicker. Let me dig in there a little bit. Let's see. Now we're kind of like making. I feel like. You know, sometimes you're painting, sometimes you're making art. And there's like this romance between the two. Okay, so, you know, lighter blue on the horizon. Especially midday, early day. It's lighter on the bottom. So let's go. We're going lighter on the bottom. Getting that white in there, and we're saying, come on. Come on, buddy. Come on, buddy. Everybody in here knew. And look at, like, it feels so good to see that blue up against the darker blue. Kind of ruined that. Oh, I love it though. Kind of actually just made it just like work. Come on, get that white in there. Come on, baby. Beautiful. I'm kind of done talking to you. Let me go a little bit higher in the mix. About these clouds and how I want to approach this. Like I said, I've never done this before. I want to go gray. How to gray this gray? Do I want to just get the black out? Or do I want to try to mix a gray or black? It's a tough decision here. Maybe if I go with elegant and a viridian thing. Try to make this black that we need. Let's try to do a little mix. Instead of going true black, let's try to make a little bit of a mix here. What we got? Here we go. We got this. This green and phthalo green. I don't know. The lighting makes the color a little wet. Okay. You guys can't really see this mix. I'm trying to make this. I got the red here. The red and green are kind of like these opposites, and make it so black. Red, green, and we're at black. Now, we really won't go over the true character of this black though, so we add a little white to it. And really good job, I feel like. It's in the green area, though. So, I'm trying to get it. Red's always, like, really dominant. So, like, when you put red into the mix, it's usually pretty dominant. So, I tried to air, you know, on the green side. I think we can air maybe on the red side because I'm using this red bass, you know what I mean? Yeah, this is cool. I think I like in the green area still a little bit. But I think it's gonna work out. I think this is gonna work out fine. I'm using a reference for this painting too over my screen a little bit. I think that's cheating. Cool. Here we go. I'll put these grays in a little bit. Yeah, no mistakes, only happy accidents, right? That's what we learned from Bob Ross. Alright, now we're gonna go remake these. Okay. Try. An Italian. Trying to get the back. Thank you very much, guys. If you like the page, it does a little alert right now. If you like this video, it should do a little alert. Comrade Kubrick, yeah, he's kind of like on a break right now. I told him he really needs to like step it up a little bit with the production value. I said, go ahead, take a couple weeks off, try to get yourself together, He kept telling me he knows a lot more about production than me, and that he's made a lot of movies or something. I kept saying, hey, this isn't a movie, it's an art show, bro. So we took a break. He's still getting paid what he deserves, I told him. No, we worked on it together, we split it. Alright guys, we got the sky in. That looks good. I do like that. I'm gonna take a little break here though, we'll be right back. Alright, we're gonna do a heavy music session here. I got the blues in here, and we're gonna slam out the music. We're gonna hit it so hard. I might have a visitor. Hold on. You're coming up for what? Whoa. Yeah. Aaron, everybody. Now you're on my show. Whoa. That'll be fun. Leo's got a new wagon, guys. Wow. Yeah.
Yeah.
Brought it out of the house. It's just like, hey, don't be wrong. Yeah, hang around.
We'll be right back. The feeling hits, you face a tension. The acid overflows.
And everything that you believe in resolves in something so
leaders concretion to misfit toys, counterculture to flow.
We used to battle for the right to live, but now we just face the show. Testify, parasite. What better way to fight the powers that be? The dirty laundry, the plastic 40s. Fuck this,
I'm dead,
a never-ending stream.
Lost my own body into steam.
The suicide of imprisoning at the seams.
Homelessness, my godliness,
a god simple.
Who am I?
The questions that you find.
Advantage, your companions will never abandon you.
You are sublime, but joy. What better way to fight the powers that be? A dirty laundry, a plastic 40s. Still you don't seem to see the irony in this egg anarchy. Yes, I'm a brother.
Make sure you guys, you know, are sharing the page, sharing the live stream if you're liking what you're seeing today. Letting people know what's going on. I see you guys are going to Instagram. I'm sorry, go pull the tab on Instagram. Instagram's a little behind right now.
All right, chat. Oh, never mind. I have a brown. I got brown. I can steal. Hold on, I got a brown back here. Couple browns. Oops. That was from my main palette though. Okay. Got some brown to work with here though. But this is kind of like. We'll be right back.
Yo. 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 Yo.
This is looking pretty cool. Yo, let's take a quick little break. We'll be right back. I'm Dustin Payev, Good Morning Artist. Now, you may be thinking, Dustin, I could never afford poster art like that. Poster art like that must cost like $1 million! And you would be absolutely right. But what if I told you there was a way you could afford this art? You would say I was crazy, right? Here, I'm not here to waste your time, friends. I can tell you what, I can get you this poster for less than $100,000. Wait, did you say less? Yes! Not only do you get everything in this poster for less than $69,420, I'll also throw in a moose, a fox, and an owl.
No!
Yes! But wait, there's more. Let's see here. Some hockey guys. I'm gonna throw in a sled ride. That's right, I'm gonna throw in some more people. That's right, I'm gonna throw in even all on the same price. I'm gonna throw in some more people. I am gonna throw in a Yeti. That's right, this poster comes with also a Yeti. All right, we're gonna go with more trees. I'm gonna add in more trees, all for the same price, folks. We're gonna add in more people. And yes, folks, we're gonna add in more people. And we're even gonna add in a creepy guy right here. Listen, we explained it on the live stream.
What live stream?
That's right, you get everything in this poster for less than $5,000. $2,000. Less than $1,000. Less than $500. What's going on? Less than $100. Less than $10.
No!
That's impossible! Ah! Yeah! You get all of this for $1.
What?
No! Dustin, that'll destroy the economy! I don't care! All you need to do to get this poster art for $1 is to head over to our patreon.com Payetteart page and subscribe for only $1. And we'll send you out this poster art guaranteed. Everyone gets one. For limited time only. Thanks, guys.
Hi, I'm Dustin Payette from Good Morning Artist, and I wanted to do some painting for you today. Hey, and I'm just gonna guide you through the crazy things that I do when I paint. Like use titanium white. No one's ever done that before. I am a genius. Okay, what else we're gonna use? We're gonna use Naples yellow. Wow, okay, wow. Totally. Futuristic. Nobody has ever used that before. Okay, I got Williamsburg Prussian blue. Yep. Okay, cool. I got Alizarin crimson. I think that's how you say it. I don't know. Can you help me? It's red, I believe, with a purple tint. That's what I'm told on other YouTube videos. Okay, here we go. We're gonna wash it with an acrylic cobalt base real quick. That's how fast I did that. That was really cool. And we just did that so we're not painting directly on the white, and I used a little sandpaper to smooth it out real quick, and boom, that was quick. Here we go, I'm using a brush. You can see I'm doing some squares. I'm gonna do squares today, do some cubist things. I was reading up on some famous artists who said they could paint in just squares, and so I said, okay, let's try that out. You know, and then I did some blocks of shapes. I got that Prussian blue right in there, blocked in. I'm just blocking in big shapes. That's what I wanted to do today. And, you know, just have a creative flow. I'm working on an 8x6 card here. So, you know, it really didn't take me long. You can see how fast I'm working. It took me only minutes to do this. I'm one of the fastest painters in the entire world. I produce about 100 of these a day, and I usually make $1,000 to $2,000 a day, because I'm able to produce so much of the art so fast. Got some orange in there. That's exciting. Finally. Maybe I'll go some red. Maybe I'll do a loop-de-loop with the clouds because, you know, I was just kind of bored with squares. I mean, how many squares could you possibly do? Those cubists, oh man. It's just squares. Anyway, so we're just having a free throw. This landscape here, getting some clouds in there, getting some more mood in there. Brilliant work. I think you should probably subscribe to this channel, and I'm sure you learned so much. So subscribe down below, and make sure you go to all the other pages, and check out all the other videos, and I love you guys being here. Get your sketchbooks out, and we're back. Hope you guys got your sketchbooks out. Hope you guys are enjoying your day. Maybe you're cleaning your room. Alright, so here we go. We're gonna keep going. I'm trying to make a really good green right now. That's really kind of popping. And for some reason, this cobalt's not really doing what I want. One sec. I want this one to pop a little bit. Look at that. So I got some cad yellow. Just because I want something to really pop off here. Sort of getting there. Just to crush it a little bit more.
We'll end, we will then meet again.
Thanks for staying with us. Keep chatting away. We'll be right back.
Yeah.
Hold up, guys. What time is it? 1 o'clock. Okay. We're doing okay. We've been painting all day. It's been going pretty good. Take a live scene of the painting right now. There it is. A couple things to do. I'm just gonna put the windmills on. You know, the little fans on the windmill there. And I got a fence to finish up on the bottom there a little bit. And maybe a couple more sheeties. I think I'm gonna darken the sky up. I need that off the top too a little bit. Real quick. And then this one was okay. It's okay. It's pretty fun though. Totally fun. Having a good time. Let's finish this up though. Let's do it.
Yeah.
Boom. We're done. We did it. I'm gonna sign it. I'm done. Patreon, maybe some other places. Appreciate everybody being here with me. Let me know if you need anything done, and get your sketchbook guys out, and good morning, everybody.